I've been asked as a member of Congress what led me to enter public service, and it's a great question. For me, it started with becoming involved as a volunteer at the community level, which I think in many ways is the best way to begin one's journey into public service. When I was working at a law firm in Baltimore, I began to do pro bono volunteer work on education issues in the community. That led me eventually to a part-time arrangement with the State Department of Education in Baltimore. So I was splitting my time between the private sector and the public sector. And then I did a lot of nonprofit work, serving on the boards of community organizations, a public interest law firm, and other groups that were trying to make a difference in the wider community. I think that when public service begins with that kind of volunteerism and being connected to your community, it naturally flows from that. And so I always encourage young people who are getting started on a career, make sure that you set aside some time to do that kind of volunteerism and service, whatever it may be that you're involved in, whatever your vocation is. Make your avocation being connected to your community and serving in some kind of volunteer capacity. From that, you develop the interest which can lead to entering public service, and whether that's entering elected office, as I've chosen to do, or whether it's serving among the ranks of the outstanding government employees that I see day in and day out here in Washington, it's an important contribution to make. In fact, I bet if you interviewed many of the federal employees who serve here in Washington and across the country, you would discover that they're the same people who, after hours in their own communities, are contributing their time through volunteerism and service. So in closing, I want to thank those who step forward and join the ranks of our public servants for all the terrific work that you do.